We'd now like to move on to some very interesting sessions lined up for the day. Our next session is in planning for tomorrow, a smart city in the making. And I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Prakash Gaur, Director of Strategy, CRDA, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Let's put our hands together for him as he steps on stage and presents to us a very smart city of Amravati.
Good afternoon, everybody. I've been given a tough task post-lunch to keep you engaged. I'll try my best. After having a lavish lunch, all of you are engaged with me. First of all, thank you very much, organizers, ET and St. Gobain, to give us this opportunity to present this beautiful case studies, city of 21st century in making. And when I say, I mean it, and I'll take you through why I'm saying this. Directly coming to the point, we begin our journey last year, June 2014. I think many of you are from India may be aware that we were bifurcated on June 2014 last year. We were left without capital and without capital. So you have no capital to build capital also. And that's how we begin our journey last year. But we progressed very fast in last 1 year, and I'll touch upon what all work has been done in last 1.5 years, starting from identification. And as you may be aware, that on 22nd of October, Honorable Prime Minister laid the foundation of this capital in presence of many international dignitaries and national dignitaries. Coming to the location part is, this pointer not work? The screen. Fine. So the important part is when you start identifying the location of capital, and I'm sure people who are from, who knows Andhra and Telugu communities very well, you are very emotional when location of capital was to be identified, this thing. And it was a very Herculean task for us to have stakeholder participation, consultation of the people's, experts' opinions, and so on and so forth. It was very well decided that the capital will be centrally located, both in the center of the state, which is on the bank of Krishna River, just across the Vijayawada city, which is another major town of New Andhra Pradesh state. Another important thing you will see that this town is also strategically located with equidistance kind of other metro towns like Hyderabad, Chennai and Bangalore for strategic reason. When we begin a journey, we also start collaborating ourselves with international partners like Government of Singapore, Government of Japan, and we are also in talk with Government of UK to support this and how they really make this city truly world class of 21st century city. So the vision was given by Honorable CM, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu. He is very well known in the country for delivering in previous tenure Hyderabad, which is known. To that he said, I want to develop a capital city, but this is a challenge for us. Let us convert into opportunities. This will not be just an administrative town. This will be more like a people's town. That's the reason the vision was given. This will be called a people's capital of Andhra Pradesh. And I'll say, tell you how it mean it. It is not just a slogan or vision for that matter. It is reflecting in each and every aspect of delivering of this city. We very well set the framework for urban sustainability. I will not bore you, all of you are expert to know the subjects. Only one circle I want to touch upon is that the jobs. It will not be just, as I mentioned, it will not be just the administrative town. This will be the economic town. This will be a town which will provide jobs and home for all sections of the society. That's how the first tone to make it people's capital of Andhra Pradesh. Just few statistics, the city is planned for 2.5 million population with 1.5 million jobs in that area. Jobs are very, very important for us when we are talking about creation of smart city of 21st century. Now, when I say people's capital of Andhra Pradesh, as I mentioned at the beginning of the statement, we left without capital and without capital. People of Andhra Pradesh came together, and I think first time in the history, and I don't recollect such large scale kind of contribution has happened by the people, that they have came together and offered their land in form of land pooling scheme to develop this capital. This is on the bank of Krishna, as I mentioned. We have almost 54,000 acres, 200 square kilometers of land is available, which sometimes become a non-starter for such kind of development. This is already in place. This was done in a record 45 days time period. Only because of, as a profession I can say, only because of leadership it is possible. The conference was given for the people, and then people came together that we want to build our capital, we will be there, we will be providing our lands. It does not mean that they have given the land, they are getting a huge compensation in form of this thing. 25% of land developed lot goes back to them. Besides that, 10 years they are getting per acre, some 30,000 rupees per acre compensations, plus jobs, plus trainings, and so on and so forth. We are talking about sustainable habitat, sustainable development. We talk about the people's participation. Without institutional encouragement, nothing happens. In the morning, someone's talking about multiplicity of the institutions. All our big cities are facing problems. We have our development authorities, we have UMTA, we have these authorities, we have this regulator. This thing is, unfortunately, we do not have a unified development and regulatory authorities in countries. So what we did first is we passed our act last year in September 2014, and then under the APCRDA Act, a Capital Region Development Authority was enacted. So the authority was created through an act. If you read our act on our webline, which is our website, it is very exhausted, covers all aspects of planning and development. It empowers authorities to deliver what it requires. So all such authorities, what you see, differently created, and the torsion, what happened to multiple authorities, torsion starts happening among the authorities, and coordination starts lacking. This is upfront plan in this area, and this authority is responsible for 8,000 square kilometer of area, which many of our mega towns start thinking in late 90s or now. What does it mean? That this is the green area, what you see, is a capital region, which is of the scale of 8,000 square kilometer. So we did the complete perspective plan first. Normally people do is, they see in silos, develop that 100, 200 square kilometer, they don't see what is happening around this thing. If you see the three or four major towns there, Guntur is there, Vijayawada is there, and Tenali, Mangalgiri, some small towns are already there in the towns. So how to strengthen those towns, how those towns can be created as a satellite nodes, how the 200 kilometer long ring, what you can see on the black line on the outer part, it is 210 kilometer long. Outer ring road is already been planned upfront at this stage, That's called planning for future, And you can see the growth corridor, the industrial nodes, residential nodes has been. It is not just a planning of a capital of few hundred acres or few hundred square kilometers. It is taking care of the entire region, people's participation, how this can really be developed. Of course, the main city of Amravati will be of 217 square kilometer. Of course, I'm sure people are familiar with the history. Amravati in the Indian history is known since 4th century BC, the relics of Stingish. So contextually and culturally, this is a very rich site. It traces from 2000 year old, and it's not just a Buddhist area. There are a couple of other sites which you can see, Kanakadurga Temple, Undavali Caves, Kondavali Forts. There are multiple locations up there which is very rich in terms of, how do we integrate them in terms of city development was also an opportunity for us. We don't see this as a challenge, because that will bring your city to a tourist destination rather than just an administrative destination, which become only Babu's town. Another contextually very important for as Andhraite for us is the Vastu. Whatever we do, even we create a small house, we first look for a Vastu. तो हाउ कैन यू बिल्ड अ कैपिटल विदाउट हैविंग विद कंप्रोमाइजिंग ऑन द वास्तु. तो फर्स्ट थिंग वॉज देन इज वन द कंसेप्चुलाइजेशन स्टार्ट हैपनिंग इज द वास्तु एक्सपर्ट कॉल एंड सी एंड वेन पीपल हू आर एक्सपर्ट इन वास्तु आई एम नॉट दैट हाउ द एक्सिस वॉज टू नॉर्थ हाउ द एक्सिस एनर्जी एक्सिस हाउ ब्रह्मस्थान हैज बीन क्रिएटेड एंड देन अकॉर्डिंग द लोकेशन ऑफ द कोर कैपिटल सीट विच ऑन द सेंटर देयर हैज बीन आइडेंटिफाइड. People talk about normal infrastructure development, but I think in the morning people are talking about, in the afternoon session people are talking about livability, spaces, common spaces. I think we have forgotten our own cities, which has really given us such a good cities. I don't know why we are really looking for other side of the world where how the cities are to be built. And you can see the main emphasis of Honorable CM is that I want to see blue and green plan. He always asks, where is a blue and green plan? There is a blue and green plan, water and the greenery in the city. I said, how I want people to be roam around the cities, either through a bicycle or through a walk or through along the canals. So there should be a network, because Vijayawada people are familiar, has a good canal network currently, which we are trying to refurbish now. Similar kind of better network can be created in the cities. Yeah. And site gives that opportunities, because site has a lot of ravines, which are channels which are going on. Can we really integrate into our planning, this thing is. You can see from the green network, you can walk throughout city from anywhere to anywhere, this thing is. That will give a really livability and walkability in the cities, which you need to really plan. And of course, the low-lying area has been converted into the water ponds, which will also help you in providing the this thing is. And there will be a 30-kilometer riverfront is being planned along the city. This is normal planning, but of course I would like to highlight that this thing is hierarchy of road is very important, this thing is. If you plan road and you know what city's planning is, that has not been done, this thing is. And just don't plan the road for this thing is. We learn from this, we need to learn from the various western part of the thing, especially in the Middle East also, that how the dynamic modeling for the cities are being done. And then I think in the morning I was hearing that one of the developer was saying that there are responsibility for the developer to do this thing, is there responsibility for the developer to do this thing is. When you propose any development, you first do an impact analysis. And that impact analysis has to be integrated into your infrastructure requirement, or primarily the transport requirement is. So one can see the red line, which is the RTL road, and then sub-RTL roads, the proper hierarchy and grid network has been planned for a smooth movement within the city. Metro, people say it's a greenfield city. There is only 100,000 people as the villagers are living. Why you're thinking about the metro? You are planning for 2.5 million population and it may grow further in the larger area. Please plan upfront. So you can see almost 80% of the MRT will be covering within 1 kilometer. 80% of the people will be covered within 1 kilometer of reach of metro. So complete TOD concept, which we learned in theories, is already been planned here. You can see blue dots. These are all metro stations which has been planned in that. The various lines which will be connecting to Vijayawada area. This gives you a complete the master plan. We have a large green chunks. As we all know from the colors, the yellow is residentials, blue is commercial, and the red is social. The capital complex comes somewhere in the center. I don't know, it's not working, that part is. So one can see what you see, the seed capital area which is written, this will be act as a CBD for the city, central business district. And the left hand side on the north to north axis, you will have complete social axis, which will be a ceremonial axis. You will have a capital seat, main capital, and then below that all the institutional buildings will be coming up. But this is just about capital. How do you bring jobs in such a greenfield city, this thing is. So we need to bring a lot of themes into this thing, is job opportunities. It is not just one component we are looking at. How do we create a specialized center of excellence within our cities to call it sub-cities, this thing is, be it health, be it sports, be it justice. Since we already created a government seat, we are also looking to create a special node for calling it a justice city, which have a lot of ancillary facilities related to justice, knowledge, business and finance, tourism, of course, as mentioned, cultural site. We are looking some industrial areas, so, but there's very light and green industries in form of electronics. So that brings to the quality of life, the livelihood, which I mentioned, habitat. habitat does not mean only for the exclusive class. There is enough provision in terms of numbers. 5% of land use has been allocated for affordable housing itself, which you need to really take care about the people is. Of course, social, recreational, cultures has to be. So this brings the complete ecosystems for creating the business opportunities in the cities. And when you translate in terms of detailed plan, this is how the area may look like from various zones which has been planned in that area, from the government city to justice city to business cities, this thing is, and what kind of population employment densities this thing is. I don't need to detail about this thing is, the only thing I will say, people are talking about what is smartness and thing. In the ante room, I was also asked that, what do you think about the smartness? I only say, as long as you can make your citizens happy, city is smart. Whether you talk technology, whether you talk livability, whether you talk about housing, if people are happy, and then Bhutan is a classical example for us, they get a gross happiness index, and that's what they call us, that's what we are is. So if we can bring our city smartness to here, people are happy. Even if I'm getting job, my life is stressed, what do I do? Even if I have a very excellent house and job, but even if I'm not happy, the major crux of the matter is if city can provide, and I'm sure, especially senior people who have seen our city in 70s and early 80s, our city provides that happiness somehow, this thing is, in all sense. So this is all livability, sustainability, anyway we'll be covering this. I'll not touch upon the detailing of infrastructure because of the paucity of time, but let me tell you very boldly, the best of the best class infrastructure will be made available as long as it is affordable for the people. You can bring moon. It has to be affordable for the people. So we will be providing the best of the best class infrastructure for the transport, energy system, water systems. We have a commitment for zero discharge. Completely water will be recycled within the cities. We have a commitment for renewable source. Vijayawada is, that region is known for solar systems, so we are having a lot of renewable productions, waste management. As a state, we are already going for a waste to energy plant at the regional level, which will integrate the cities. And of course, ICD will play a big role, which will have a complete centralized, how the entire city will be managed, whether it's from fire point of view. Here, I want to touch upon this thing is, even our police is working closely with CRDA. When we are talking about security master from the city, it is not the, it's police job is. CRDA and security, commissioner of police, together are working to create a workshop and then putting a security master plan, because it cannot be just somewhere else babies. And then I design something is, because today's security system is not just technology, it's also how you design your city, how you plan your city, how the infrastructure is being planned. And if I go into the detail for the architect, another thing is how your curb, how your bollards, how your barriers are being planned, how your common hotspots are being planned, how your common spaces are being planned. This is very important when we're talking about the policies. So security people have to be bring upfront while doing this planning. Skill development is very important when you're talking about jobs for all, but the most important for 100,000 people who are living in 29 villages in that area, who has offered their land to us. We are training them, doing this thing. Just 2 minutes, I'm finishing. Urban design, I think all of you are experts, so not a problem, but I just want to touch upon a couple of things is, urban design is not just building facade and the curbs and this thing is. How the area is being planned, common area is being designed, make it for the people is very important. And that should be completely clean, how it is being maintained. So it's been really taken care. This is how the entire roads will look like of this area. How the integrated township model will be there around those nine cities, what we are saying is, each will be around 4 square kilometer of townships, because we need to return 25% land to the private landowners. How they are also being benefited from the land which they're getting it. So for their commercial, residential needs has to be taken care, which can be really given benefit to them. To this thing is. This is how Amravati is being planned for future development. This will be, believe me, this will be the future city for 21st century. This is how the city will look like. Some images being created for the city. Thing is. This is what we are very ambitious. Our CM, everybody knows how he works. So by 2018 and all of know why 2018 and 2019 will be, the country will again be facing the political thing is. So that there will be a delivery, not only there's common complex, the business cities, the complete infrastructure, so you will be seeing in next 3 to 4 years the complete city up and running, coming on these parties. That's what our vision is, that bring happiness to the people of Andhra, and then we're able to develop people's capital of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you very much. You're putting me in the center of the stage.
Sir, we want you to be in the limelight. Please join us. I'd like to thank you, and I'd like to invite Mr. Rishi Kapoor on stage to honor your presence. And may I also request Mr. Anand Tanikela from St. Govind to join us on stage. And thank you for your presence. Let's put our hands together. Sir, you are on center stage. It's very difficult to actually host a session right after lunch. And you took up the job of doing the most difficult session. So we'd like to thank you for your presence. Once again, let's put our hands together for him. And a Smart Green certificate for you, sir. May I request you to join us for a group picture? Thank you so very much.